Harpers Ferry Day Hike, Weverton Cliffs to Ed Garvey Shelter. This is part of the Cornucopia Tour. Though this is not Harpers Ferry, it neighbors it, and the experience is very similar to the two trails in Harpers Ferry, the Maryland Heights Trail and the Loudoun Heights Trail. So if you were to achieve a Harpers Ferry Day Hike Triple Crown, it would include Weverton Cliffs. The total trail length from the Weverton Cliffs parking lot to Weverton Cliffs and then to the Ed Garvey Shelter is over 3.2 miles. The combined elevation or gain is over 1,050 feet. The parking lot for this trail is a 1.98 mile drive to the Virginia outskirts of the Harpers Ferry area. You can also see Harpers Ferry from much of this trail. Here's what's known as the Weverton Cliffs parking lot, but the sign there reads Park and Ride. Mistake number one, it's 2:26 p.m. and the sunset is at 5:32 p.m. That's 3 hours into a 4 hour hike. Most day hikers have already come and gone. Here is the Weverton Cliffs trailhead. Here is the welcome sign. In some spots, it's tough to tell what the actual trail is. The white blazes help with that. There are several double white blazes on the trail. They are vertically aligned with each other. This poster from the Appalachian Trail Conservancy explains what that means. There are many switchbacks with stone stairs. Here is the junction sign where the Weverton Cliffs Blue Trail splits off from the Appalachian Trail. I will walk by this sign two more times on this hike. That's Harpers Ferry there, where you can see some old bridge supports, and behind it, a bridge. I only captured the end of it, but some hikers heated up some soup at the overlook and had it for lunch. There is a lot you can see here at this overlook, but most of it is on the right. From right to left, the four most important points I'd like to mention are Maryland Heights, Harpers Ferry, Loudoun Heights, and the Appalachian Trail. This is the Weverton at-grade railroad crossing. It has no gate or lights. It is the only legal place for pedestrians to cross the tracks in the Harpers Ferry to Weverton area. The crossing is for Appalachian Trail hikers, river access, and CNO canal access. Use extreme caution if crossing here. I'm going to leave the Weverton Cliffs area now and head to the Ed Garvey shelter. Here's the junction sign again. This is the second of three times that I will see it today. On the way to the shelter, the trail is relatively flat. There's also not much to see. However, I did find what is possibly eastern coyote scat on the way. The eastern coyote is also known as a coy wolf. Many have wolf and domestic dog genes. I captured one on a trail cam about 4 miles away. My veterinarian estimates it to weigh about 65 pounds. That is the Jefferson or east side of the ridge. There is a rocky outcrop on this side that extends the entire length to the shelter. Okay, this is the shelter. The first thing I want to do is try to reflect the sun to my home in the valley on the east that is 5 miles away. I have a small bathroom mirror to do that with. I have family members in my home kitchen with a much larger mirror. They will try to signal me with it. This will allow me to pinpoint the location of my home from the shelter and to pinpoint the location of the shelter from my home. I will video them and they will video me. Here is the view from my kitchen. From a telescope, I can see the shelter roof gable. I know that is it because when it snows, I can see the right side shape of the roof. This is the smaller mirror. You can see the signals that I was able to send. This is the larger mirror. You can see the signals that my family member was able to send from my home. After stopping to reflect sun to my home and look around the shelter area, I started to get quite cold. 5 minutes from noticing this, I became extremely concerned. I was miles from any roads and began to shiver and continued to feel colder. I was wearing 4 layers, but my inner 2 layers were soaked from this deep hike up to the cliffs. A section hiker was building a campfire, and I told him what happened. He asked if I was wearing cotton, and I was. My bottom 2 layers were cotton. He said I needed to replace those layers with dry layers. I had a moisture-wicking long-sleeve shirt with me, so I changed into that. It felt like it was about 19 to 20 degrees. It was tough to take off my top clothing in that cold. In about 5 to 10 minutes of warming up by the fire, I was fine. I was very surprised about how that crept up on me so fast. If I had been alone and had no extra shirt, I could have succumbed to hypothermia. The shelter has a guest book that I signed. More on that later. About the cold season weather conditions on this ridge, it is approximately 5 to 7 degrees colder than the valleys below it. Here are three picks from 2019 that I took when it rained in the valleys but snowed on the ridge. This ridge also gets a constant breeze when the valleys don't. The spring is 0.4 miles down the east side of the ridge. I'm heading back now because the sun is setting, but a little about me and the trail name I put in the guestbook. My guestbook entry reads, Icicle, first time here, day hike, I'm freezing. Icicle is my trail name. I gave it to myself when on a hike on a recent cold day. It was 0 to 5 degrees Fahrenheit and icicles were growing on my eyelashes and then falling off. Distracting, but also exciting. I prefer not to focus on myself here, except to state that I can identify most of the animals I see. I've always lived in the South Atlantic US, and I travel to Florida. I have a strong fondness for Florida and the Appalachian Trail. My time in the Southeast US is relevant because that may explain my naivete when handling being in the cold outdoors for large periods of the day. Today, a very important safety lesson was learned. This is likely the fire road that was used during the building of the shelter in 2001. It's about 100 yards from the shelter. The shelter sleeps 12 to 25 people, by the way. The sun has just set. Those lights are from Harpers Ferry and the horse race tracks in Charlestown, West Virginia. Those lights are from Brunswick, Maryland. Brunswick is at the southern end of Jefferson, Maryland. It's the junction sign again. This is the third and final time I'll pass by it this outing. Now it is completely dark. I cannot see where I am stepping, so I must use my headlamp. This headlamp has served me well for as long as I can remember, but for this rocky excursion, I realized that it doesn't light up anything beyond 10 feet. So if a bear were 15 feet in front of me, I wouldn't see it until I was less than 10 feet away from it. I will look for a model with more coverage. There is a glimpse of the parking lot. Thank goodness. There is the only trail counter I've seen here. Back at last. Happy trails and safe travels.